Welcome to our new lecture, The City of Brandon in Manitoba. In this lecture, we will explore a little bit about Brandon. It's considered one of the 10 choices, best places to live in Canada, based on the latest surveys. So we're gonna learn a little bit about the city and what the city can offer to potential immigrants. So let's take a look. Brandon is the second largest city in the province of Manitoba, Canada. It's located in the southwestern corner of the province on the banks of the Assiniboine River, approximately 214 kilometers west of the provincial capital of Winnipeg and 120 kilometers east of the Saskatchewan boundary. That is based on the Wikipedia information. In regarding to the demographics of the city, you can see that the population of Brandon has been increasing since 2001, with the latest number from 2016, and this is provided by Town Folio. So the last numbers is 48,859 people living in the city. The household income, you can see the brackets, and the majority is a middle class population. And when we see the key metrics, the median household income is 65,960. There's 7,535 members of the visible minority. The average age is 36.3, which is considered so far one of the younger cities that we cover in this course. You have a population of Aboriginals around 6,415, and the cohort age is between 25 and 29. Basically, it's a very young city and will be ideal for people that are looking to grow and develop in a young city in Canada. When it comes to the labor force, we can see here that the main industries are retail, manufacturing, construction, healthcare, education, and accommodations. Interesting to see also that the participation of that labor force is the majority are in sales and services. We understand that because of the accommodation part. They have also a big chunk in natural resources, education, law and government, businesses, and healthcare. Unemployment rate is 7.3, and basically they have a participation rate of 69.9%. The largest industry in the city is healthcare, and the biggest occupation is sales and service. When it comes to taxes, well, they follow the same information about brackets. We can see here that at the federal personal income tax, 50% start at 48,535, and then the brackets continue to grow based on these percentages. Then also in the provincial personal income tax, these are the percentages, and they can see the brackets starting at 33,389, and it continues to increase. Not many brackets, so which is good news for immigrants. Also, they have different structures for businesses. You can see all these metrics here in this chart. When it comes to temperatures here in Brandon, we can see that the month of January is the coldest month, around 40.8% degrees, and continue during the winter time. About the snowfall, you have some snow beginning in October, and it continues all around till some in May. So it's basically due to the fact that it's in the middle of the country. When they get enough snowfall during the year. Now, if we value the information of the weather, we can see that the highest temperature in summertime will be 33 degrees, a little hotter than other places in Canada. And then minus 41 will be the lowest temperature. We see the average yearly snowfall is 101 centimeters, and the highest rainfall month will be September, when they experience a lot of rain. When it comes to housing, the majority of people own a home in Brandon, and the rest of the people, 7,720, are renters. There's an even distribution between 3 bedrooms and 2 bedrooms in the area of Brandon, and a lower proportion of 4 bedroom rooms. There's around 12,550 homeowners. The average rent in the city is $894, which is cheaper compared to other cities. And the average house is $271,621. So this is the average prices of housing in the city of Brandon, Manitoba. When it comes to transportation, the majority of people owns a vehicle in Brandon. Then you have a smaller proportion with vehicle passengers and public transportation. The busiest time of the road will be between 7 a.m. and almost 8 a.m. And you can see that very few people use the public transportation due to the fact that most of the people own a car. Education, most of the population in the city of Brandon have a high school degree. Other people, another portion, have no certificate. And then you have some university people, 7,000 university degree. And then you have different degrees around the city. Apprenticeship is big, and it's a good thing to take into consideration if you're moving to Brandon. We see also that when it comes to engineering and retail, it's a big chunk of the field that they study people in the city, health and related, and also businesses. When it comes to business, the majority of businesses are in the retail sector, followed by businesses in healthcare, manufacturing, and wholesale. You also have presence of mining companies and also accommodations. The majority of the employers in the city of Brandon are small businesses from 1 to 4 employees, followed by another business with 5 to 9 employees. The biggest employer is in real estate, and followed by healthcare businesses. There's around 64 companies in the manufacturing sector in Brandon. Now let's take a look at their presence online. Here we are at the website of the city of Brandon. Here you can check the services that you might need in the city and the community and the services that you can check and explore if you're looking to learn about the city and what they offer. You have Brandon Tourism if you want to get information about the main sites for tourists. Also on the complex, recreation, art, diversity, and history about Brandon. So you can get all the information by visiting the website. Also, you can check the city services here. When it comes to streets and roads, information about plans, utilities, licenses, everything that you might need curious about, you can find in the city services. And also, you can check their presence when it comes to opportunities that they can offer. We can see that they are also educational institution that you might be interested in. For example, a good idea would be to study in Brandon, and for that we're going to check 2 institutions that you might consider. We're going to start with Brandon University. In here, this is Brandon, this is the website. It's located in the city of Brandon. Here you have the information about scholarships and programs, and when I look for information specifically about students, okay, check the programs of the university. So once we click programs, then you can see the information, all the degrees and that they can offer, and certificates. If you're looking for a small period, 2-year certificate or program, you can find and explore that information right here. And tuition information, you have international tuition table that you can download. International graduate tuition table. So you have the information for international students. If you're looking for, just download it and you'll be able to find it. Another institution that you can consider for education purposes and eventually for the immigration pilot program would be Assiniboine Community College. And here you can find information about the programs that they offer. So if you look for admission, then you can have the international applications right here. You click there. And then you have the step-by-step how to apply for the program in this college. It's a community college. You can find programs for 2 years. And just as far as you understand that they meet all the requirement for a study permit, then you should be good. All right. Just check the website and get familiar with all the information. And just verify that it can benefit from the immigration pilot program too. You can find also the Facebook page of Brandon City, Brandon Tourism. They have pictures, videos, and everything that you need. You can send messages to them. And hopefully you get familiar with activities, get contact with people, ask some questions. If you go to photos or videos about the city, community. So we highly recommend that you follow it on Facebook. And finally, you can subscribe to the YouTube channel of the college in Manitoba and also the university. And you can find information about the school also by checking their YouTube channel. And that way you can ask information if you want one of those programs. Nursing is a big field in this college. So I suggest you to take a look at it. I hope you enjoyed this lecture and we'll see you in the next one.